as they come up on a 3rd and 11. Vic to throw it. Open receiver, that's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, a 22.
And how about that throw? We saw a combination of elite arm strength and obviously the ability to move the sticks with that completion. But it's the way that he throws the ball, so compact, yet the ball comes off of his hand and it just whistles to the receiver.
Drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield. It'll be a pickup of just 2, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. So after the run by Kamara, now another 1st and 10. Vic will look to throw on 1st down. Forced out to his left. And Cook has it, left side. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability, you've had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down. Second down, Vic. It's caught, and he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Hayden Hurst, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Packers take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. Point after by Lambeau, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. First carry now for Dalvin Cook. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Minka Fitzpatrick made the play defensively, the first round pick out of Alabama.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
On 2nd down, Cook. He'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 23.
In today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run, probing now early to try and get things done later.
It's Jackson, and he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A 10-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Charger 1st down.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the 1st drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big 3rd down pickup to keep their drive alive.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on 1st down. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on 1st down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. They pitch it out to Cook. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Any team that runs the toss and runs it successfully, that means they win the battle on the edges. That means you seal the edge in order to let your back get to the corner. They got it done there for a very nice game.
And now on the pitch, the ball's loose. And this is going to be Packer football. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter about to get underway with the Packers in possession of the football. They've got it first and 10 following the fumble recovery. Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. And coming up on their second drive of the game, had the touchdown last time out. Now they have the football back. Chance to really seize early momentum.
Feels to me like they had a really excellent week of practice. It all came together, but I'll bet you it got galvanized in the locker room and pregame. Somehow I think the head coach, his oratorical skills were on point.
And he's going to be taken down right at the line. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
Well, the defensive guys won't be real happy because there won't be a sack on this play because he did get back to the line of scrimmage. But what a job they did overall. Hemmed him in and gave him nowhere to go with the football.
And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
Flushed out right. And he's got a man, Corey Davis. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. 27 yards, a big play there on fourth. A first down throw coming for Vic. Being chased out left. And that is incomplete. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver that time. And that'll bring up second down.
I like the play call. Roll him out. Give him a chance to run it or throw it. In this situation, he decided to fling it, but couldn't find his man open.
Throwing again, Vic on second and 10. Dancing to his left. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third
down. Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. And he's wrapped up. Taken down, back at the 25. Malik Jackson in there to get him for a loss of 9, and that'll lead to fourth down. Josh Lambeau will attempt the field goal. He's a former Charger, remember, back in their San Diego days. From the left hash, this will be a 41-yarder. And Lambeau will put this one through, and the lead moves to 10-0. So chalk that down as an 8-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they were moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
Jackson now to return. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Charger offense making their way back out there. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. And they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield and punch in the end zone without turning it over.
A toss to Cook, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to more NFL action on EA Sports after this. On third down, Vic. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the one-yard line. A great pick, nice return, but you know he's just beating himself up inside for not getting all the way in.
No doubt about it, because he had visions of end zone in his mind, going to be the total hero. But we did see there the emphasis on it's not just good enough to pick it off anymore. Bring it back, get the yardage, and really help out your offense.
He'll get it up the middle. No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal. Another shot from the one on second and goal. They'll run it with Williams. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. Ricky Williams taking it in from a yard out. And the Packers add on to their lead. Extra point tacked on by Lambeau. And that makes our score 17-0. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. Jackson now to return. Gets around him. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath, first do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. To the air here after the INT on the last drive. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. First and 10, here's Vic. Now Vic stripped, he lost the football. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. He already had the one fumble loss, so now two fumbles lost here in this first half.
Not setting the pace the way that you want it done. I mean, here in the first half, already twice the ball's come out and hit the turf. Gotta find a way to take care of it. Otherwise, they may have to start thinking about maybe someone different at that position.
Now a pitch out to Kamara. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. The Pro Bowl corner, Jason Barrett on the tackle.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
Toss play, Kamara, and he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. He'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading the play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Here's Vic. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara, and he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Now on fourth down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. And that is not going to get missed it short. It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it, and this one winds up no good.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. To throw, Vic. Steps away to his left. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. This will be the final play of the half. Vic, he sets to fire deep. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Jackson now to return. And he'll be taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now to start this third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset?
A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Derwin James with a pick, and his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
I'm not sure, Brandon, we've seen a sloppier played game this year for a team on offense. Turn it over four times and expect to win? No chance whatsoever. And look, I have no idea what the ratio is about turnover four times and how that correlates to winning or losing. But I'll guarantee you, it's not very good.
A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They go play action here on first down. To the right side and complete to Hurst. A good pickup there, a 22.
Well, from an offense's perspective, that sure was pretty because the corner route is extremely difficult to defend from my perspective.
What we just saw there, is that sort of the evolution of the tight end position?
Yeah, I think it is because more and more tight ends are being treated like wide receivers. These are some agile players who can make a play in any spot on the field.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Again, it's Vic. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Now a play fake here on first down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Cam Chancellor not dropping into coverage. He comes on the blitz and takes him down for a loss of 9. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19.
Eagle.
It's a play fake. Now Vic escaping the pressure right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
Third and long for Vic. On the check down, he finds Kamara. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. And it's a 15-yard pickup, but it'll lead to a fourth down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. You like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion. What you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side. Vic readies to throw. Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Malik Jackson in there to get him for his second sack of the night. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Now here's Vic. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. So put another three on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the third quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
Oh, and this is going to wind up a safety. And the safety there, another mistake, and these mistakes just keep piling up.
How many more can they make? They put themselves in such a massive hole now, it's going to be difficult to dig out from under.
Yeah, for sure they can't afford any more at this point. And some room to roam now.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
So good field position for the Packers as they come up first and 10.
Mike 20.
Here's Michael Vick. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Throwing, Vic. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Vic operating on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Sometimes you just have to take things into your own hands, don't you? I mean, the offense is really struggling in this game. They're the ones keeping things going. They have to continue to play at that level.
From the 21, it's second and 10. On second down, Vic again. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. The Packers on third down. They've had their troubles. Just 1 for 6. This is third and 10. Play action now, Vic. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Plus like that in just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
Fourth down, Vic. Hit as as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. The Packers unable to pick up the first, and the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. So out come the Chargers. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get, and it's just so strange to see that go up on the board, and then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
Vic will look to throw on first down. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. Oh, and now Vic throwing another interception. Derwin James with a pick, and they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.